Hey, hey, dropping in real quick on this Saturday to show y'all how she turned out. Do you see that loveliness? Do you see it? I'm trying to, let you see. I put her hands back on. You know, she got the kind of hands you can just pull them out and pop them back in, okay? And so I said, let me just let y'all see and everything. This hippie girl, she get ready to get some clothes, okay? She got to get something on. But her hair is gorgeous, and I knew that it would be this way. I wanted to show y'all yesterday, but baby, it's hot. And I was in here getting things together, trying to situate situations and everything. But do you see? After the nice conditioning treatment, I just kind of rinsed her and let her stand up on this cloth here. And she was like this, and her hair was nice and wet. And she just stood like this up against my tripod. And she just, got dried out and everything. So that little balding scalp that I talked about in her head, this is how her scalp looks. But, it's made that way. But she's got a full head of hair. And it's easy to comb through with the big side and the small side. It can just, run right through. I love a doll with red hair. Ever since Ariel came out from, The Little Mermaid, and that long, red, beautiful hair, I love a doll with red hair. I wanted to dye my hair like this a couple years back. About 12 years ago, 10, 12. My grandson is 12. So before he was even born, I wanted to dye my hair this color. And I wasn't sure if to do it. I wasn't sure, So I didn't do it. I see a piece of lint or something. And then when I started seeing a little piece of silver strand or two show up, I really didn't want to dye my hair because I did not want to lose, what the color would look like of gray blending into my hair. So I have this old side. Okay, I was cleaning out some clothes of my grandson, and I came across this little footy sock, ankle sock, that I don't have a mate to. And I said, well, let's make her something out of that. It's going to be simple, okay? So we're just going to cut it right in half at the ribbed part, okay? And we're going to pick some of the lint off because, it's black. And we're just going to pick it a little bit. This is how I made doll clothes when I was young, a little girl. We cut up socks or, the strap off of a old shirt or something like that. Something that we could just sew together ourselves, and make something. So socks make for good little skirts. And that's what we're going to give her, okay? Around her little hips. Because she yet out here in her bikinis, okay? All right, she got a little sweater skirt that might be a little bit too up for her. She don't like it like that, okay? But we got this little piece for her to cover up. I thought it was okay. She got a little t-shirt or whatever this is, a crop top type of situation. It's probably on upside down. It looks like it. Let's turn it around. I ain't checked none of it, y'all. Uh-oh. I just, picked her up out of the gutter somewhere off the sidewalk. Oh, we're sorry. We don't mean to do those kinds of things, okay? All right. So, I'm not even going to get into the whole Barbie thing because, the things I see with dolls and stuff like that, I'd be like, oh, okay, we're not doing none of that with our dolls. But whatever they're doing, okay? So, you see she's turned over because we're yet exposed and we're not doing that like that, okay? So, the shirt was upside down. And everything. I don't know what RH is. And she's got some kind of letters on her cheek. And I know in my other video, I think the first one when I found her, I was like, I don't know if she's an LOL doll or Brat doll. No, she's a Brat doll. It must be a new Brat type of doll. Because I had a Brat doll and Brats didn't look like this. But they're so much prettier. I thought. But this doll eyes, you know, look like you can see through this part. But she's got, look like, you know, I don't know what that is, like fire. Okay, and that's right there. F, is that R? Might be RHL. Okay, with this fire, I don't really know what it is. And is that supposed to be there? I don't know. But her eyelashes are like real. I just love that. That's so cute about her and everything. And I love her little makeup there and everything. So her little skirt is a little big for her and everything. So we might want to do something to make it a little fitting for her. Okay? So that means we had to draw it in and everything like that. So how are we going to do that? Oh, gosh. Here we go. I didn't know it was going to be this long. Let's cover her up and everything. So I'm just going to turn this over like this. And we're going to go ahead and give it a little bit of sewing happening. Okay? Because clearly she needs something. Okay? So I'm just going to just go ahead and do something right there. Cut that right there. I think I got needle and thread right here. I do. This is the wrong color. What do I have here? I have this gold yarn here. This, okay, great. Okay, this is some kind of gold thread. Okay, let's put that back on there. Hold on. All right. Well, we have this. So let's use this in this great sewing needle that they sold me from Temu. Okay. Let me see if something is blocking this. Okay, this is not what I was going to do, but since her skirt is so large, we'll just go ahead and we'll make her fit this a little bit better. Let's see if we can find us. Move this chair that's behind me because I'm warm, okay? I'll be in here sweating and hot. And somebody says, it's been in the 90s, you ain't turn your air on? No, I ain't turn my air on. Because I'm not mad about it being 90 and 100 today and all of that. I got several fans, and as long as I can have a fan blowing on me, I don't mind a little sweat, okay? Because I'm in here moving things around and getting stuff situated. I'm not sure if I'm going to have to move. I hope not. But I'm acting like if I do have to, I should start moving some things around and toward a box that is not already packed up, okay? That's where I'm at. And we're just going to keep moving in that vein until we understand what's going to happen. Apparently, some new owner has acquired this property from the auction that happened in April. But I haven't gotten any paperwork about it. But somebody came to my house and left a card for me to call. I called them. They haven't returned my call. So we just right here doing what we doing. It's okay, baby. I didn't mean to drop that weapon on you like that. I'm sorry. I got to focus. Okay, so we got that. We doubled the thread and everything. And we just going to go this way. Because we took off some of this. Okay. Let's kind of even this piece up a little bit more. Just a little bit. And let's see how we're going to do this. It should work. We're not going to do anything all drastic and elaborate. We're just going to stitch it together a little bit. We're going under the bottom so that we can pull it with that thread and then over top of that corner. And now that's closed. And then we're just going to come over and over and over and over. And that's it. And we don't have to really focus on, you know, where it's going to be when it's stitched together, because it's black. We're using black thread, and we just need to tighten the little sock up so that it can be fitting. Okay. Now I'm going to cut this little piece off right here real quick because it looks like it's going to be lumpy. Okay. So we just pull that off too. Put that off to the side and just go ahead over here again and up under here. My mother used to sew by hand when I was a little girl, and I used to watch her. And when I became an adult, I said, oh, I don't have no time to throw clothes away because the button is missing or some kind of little tear under the arm or somewhere. You see, we're going back down, giving it a little double stitch. And then this long needle is too long, but I'm gonna just put it in there one time right there. And then I'm gonna cut this. And I watched my mother and said, you know, mommy did it, I can do it. And I wasn't that great at it at first, but I sew really well by hand, if I should say so myself. But I'm not doing it right here. I'm just, you know, doing a little something for a little doll. I don't even know what I want to call her, you know, because I don't know what kind of doll she is. I just know she's real cute. Okay, so we right there, and we sewed that, and we tied it up. I see a long piece and a long piece. Oh, we didn't mean to be having her exposed. So now this is what we got when we sewed it together. That's it, okay? So we're gonna just, you know, pull this on up like this for her. Woo! And it's sweater, and it's okay. It's still a little bit loose, but it's better. And we can just give her a little bit of belly showing so she can feel like something. I don't really know, like she's a young lady and not a old granny or something. You know, not to offend anybody because I'm in the granny group. She still looks like she need a little bit more tightening like that. Okay, she need a little bit more tightening. We should maybe make it like this. Maybe we should make it like that. It's got to be real tight around her belly. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. It's okay. We not mad. It's all right. We're just going to go ahead and do it one more time. It's just a little bit of sewing thread. You see I have all of this? Okay. We just cut that right on off. Say, oh, it's a waste of time. Maybe it's a waste of time, but it's really not. So what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to angle this piece off. I'm going to angle that off just so it fits around her belly real tight right there, okay? That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to cut this little ragged edge off, okay? And we're going this way. It's not going to take that long. It's okay. It's only, you know, a couple minutes. We're just 12:32 on the clock. It's okay. Let's just go ahead and get us another little piece of yarn. We'll need too much. That should be good. Cut that. And then we doubled it the first time. We always double it. Even though this is thick, this is not like the little 97-cent spool you can get at Walmart or Family Dollar somewhere. And we just doubled it over. Now we got a little loop, if you can see that. You see it? Okay. And then I hold that close to my hand and slide it right through the eye of the needle. And then now we got four strands working at one time like that. I just rolled it around my finger like you saw me. Let me see. I did like this. And it's around my finger. Then I grabbed this, like this piece right here. I grabbed it right there onto my finger and I rolled it like this. And now it's rolled together, and then I grabbed it like that. Now it's in a knot. It's double knot now. So that's where we at with that. So here we go. Let's just sew the little thing together again real quick. Real quick, we just go in and do it one more time. We're going to come in here, but out the bottom and close the bottom piece up. Keep that little loop right there at the bottom like that and pull it tight. Then we're going in this way. See, that looped over by itself. Now I got to move that over here on top of that corner. Now that part is looped at the bottom and tight and right there. So like that. Okay? That's what I did the first time. That's what I'm doing this time. And I just got to keep the loop up top or else it'll keep grabbing down there. I don't want it to do that. Oh, we pulled the piece of the elastic. It's trying to go somewhere. All right, and now come in here and just pull this together. It'll be fine. Okay, all right, then we go in here. We're not gonna go down, I don't think, because I cut the little angle off and it's going to be, see, it's almost out of yarn. So I'm just going to pull this up here and I hope I got enough to go to the very top. Because this long needle is just incredible. Okay, but you see, it worked. Pull it nice and tight, and I'm going to go backwards because the needle too long for me to come over it like this. It's going to be all the way over there. I need it to go right there. But it ain't doing that for me right now. So while I was sewing, a little piece of the elastic pulled onto the sock. All of these are elastic pieces. So I'm just going to, I want to go across it one more time, but I don't think I, you know, this is just very awkward and stupid. Let's see. Oh, we got it, but it's not exactly where we want it. We want it up here some more. But anyway, we're going to let it go because the needle too long. The needle is too long, honey. Let me put this back up here. And we'll tie this together. So I've been in here working a little bit on some stuff in here. Not too much because, child, I don't even know. Part of me want to pack up my whole table right here for all of my junk journal stuff. But I don't know. It's like I'm just staying prayerful and see how the Lord works it out for me and everything. Okay? I would hate to be packing everything and then they say, no, no, no. We don't want to look for a new tenant. You've been here. So we want to keep you here. Something like that. So now it's tight and it's small and it's got this little, I guess, enough space, but can I get that past her little hips? Because she's a little hippie girl, okay? She got some hips going. So let's slide this up. All right, here we go. Now, that's what we got. We got that. And now she looks better, right? Because there's no space. And that came out like this. Oh, that fits perfect. You see how it's like a, you know, like a V or something because of the angle I cut, and then this fits right in there. Okay, okay, not too bad, not too bad. We can't give her no split or nothing because, you know, then it won't even make no sense. So we're good right there, and she's good. Okay, she looks cute. She's so cute. She needs a name. I don't know what I want to name her. Okay. So we got this, and I said I should bring her a ponytail holder down here and put on her hair, but I don't know if I want to. I said we can just cut her a piece of this sock and make her something, okay? So let's just do that, okay? How you gonna do that? I'm gonna just cut a piece of this sock, okay? I'm gonna cut, what in the world is that? I don't know. I'm just cut the front of the sock all the way against the edge, up the front, to the toe, like that. Now I got this, and now I can just stretch it, and we can just come under here and tie it on her hair. Okay, and just tie it on her hair. It's not... it's not the way I want it because her hair is pulling, it's pulling backwards. Okay, let's try and get it going one more time. One more time, y'all. Okay, we're going to come this way and let's see if we can keep it pulled down nice and tight. I don't know, but I'm going to try. I'm going to try. All right, and then we can just tie it like that. And let's see, can we get a little bow? She got a little bow. It's not the best, but it's okay. She got a little bow. She looks cute, right? She looks cute. Let's go up high. Let's go up high. Let's go up high. And this is how she's looking. Okay? This is how she's looking. And she's got her hair in a little bow. can't really see this piece over here, but that's where it is. Little cute. Yeah, I like it. Worked out pretty cool. Now I can just put her somewhere. Maybe I'll keep her right here. Her hair smells delightful too. And it's just so pretty. Just so pretty. So that's it, y'all. I just wanted to show y'all, and here we go with all this beautiful hair. I'm so glad I rescued her. I was glad that I was outside when I was to get her, because she should not be in a landfill somewhere. She is so pretty. Okay? And so that's it. Hope you enjoyed this little Dolly video. And we'll see ya soon. I got all this trash, y'all, for a junk journal. And I want to do one of them. But maybe I'll come back in a little while and do the next sticker page. But I'm ready to work on a journal. I am. I'm supposed to be working on my book. Writing. I'm still in chapter 2 where I was last week. Actually, the week that school closed, which was June the 13th. I'm still right there. But I had to do what I have to do, and that's just what that is. And meanwhile, this is why I haven't been coming with any journals that I'm working on, really, because I can't do everything, and I have to prioritize the things that are important and, you know, act like I'm very focused, because I need to be very focused. All right, so this is our little doll update, and I'll probably come back and do a sticker video tonight at some point, maybe right after I finish this. I don't really know, but yeah. So there we go. See y'all soon. I don't know what her name should be. Maybe you should tell me. I don't know. Maybe we'll call her 86. Who in the world knows? Okay. All right. Peace.